press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello children, subject social science, topic ancient civilizations, class 6th, okay. In this class, we study about 5th civilization, that is Roman civilization. In previous class, we already learned about 4 civilization, Egypt civilization, Mesopotamian civilization, Chinese civilization and Greek civilization, isn't it? Now, we are going to study about the Roman civilization. In this lesson, we study about political history of Roman civilization and we study about Julius Caesar, the famous king of Roman civilization, Julius Caesar and then Augustus Caesar. Okay, children, Italy is a peninsula that stretches deeply. Italy is a peninsula. Italy is a peninsula that stretches deeply into the Mediterranean Sea and is the south of Europe. Okay, it is the European continent. Once again, Italy is a peninsula that stretches deeply into the Mediterranean Sea and is to south of Europe. Okay, it is in the European continent. It is situated or it is placed into the south of European continent, southern part of European continent. Okay, the tribal community called Latin had inhabited this land. Understood? Inhabited means what, children? It means they were dwelling or lived in the land. Okay, once again, the tribal community called Latin. Tribal community called Latin. Okay, Latin had inhabited this land. Inhabited means they were dwelling or lived on this and in this land. Rome was founded about 2500 years ago. Rome was founded about 2500 years ago. In the district of Latium. Which district? In the district of Latium. Okay, Rome was founded about 2500 years ago in the district of Latium. Okay, south of the Tiber River. It means the Roman civilization flourished on the bank of river Tiber River. Which river? Tiber River. This Roman civilization flourished on the bank of river Tiber. This also dates back to 2500 years ago. Okay, it was founded in the district of Latium. Romulus and Remus were the ancestors of the Romans. Who are the ancestors of the Romans? Romulus and Remus. Once again, Romulus and Remus. They were the ancestors of Romans. Understood, children? Once again, who are the ancestors of the Romans? Romulus and Remus were the ancestors of the Romans. Okay. Next, these two ethnic groups were the ancestors of Romans. In India, we use Aryans, Dravidians. Understood? Romulus and Remus were the ancestors of the Romans. Next, now we study about political history of Roman civilization. Political history. Political history of Roman civilization. Okay, here we see children, Pompey, Crassus and Julius Caesar. They formed the first triumvirate in Rome. Understood? Who formed the first triumvirate in Rome? Crassus and Julius Caesar. They formed the first triumvirate in Rome. Triumvirate means ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಒಕ್ಕೂಟ, ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಆಡಳಿತ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಹೇಳಬಹುದು. ಈ ಮೂರು ಜನ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡು ಅವರು ಆಡಳಿತವನ್ನು ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಪಾಂಪೆ, ಕ್ರಾಸಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್, ದೇ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರಿಮ್ವಿರೇಟ್ ಇನ್ ರೋಮ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರಿಮ್ವಿರೇಟ್. Who formed this? Pompey, Crassus and Julius Caesar, they formed first triumvirate in Rome. Understood? They formed the government. It means three important political persons were interested in forming the government in Rome. Okay? They were taking decisions. Here we see three persons are there. Isn't it? They formed the first triumvirate. Which are they? They were Pompey, Crassus and Julius Caesar. They formed the government. Understood? They have interest in forming the government. They were taking decisions. Understood? They ruled over different regions as military general. Who ruled here? Pompey, Crassus and Julius Caesar. They formed first triumvirate and they ruled over different regions as military generals. They were taking decisions very strictly. They wanted to control the Roman people. Julius Caesar and Augustus Caesar were the very most important persons in the political history of Rome. Understood? Who are the very important persons in political history of Rome? Julius Caesar and Augustus Caesar, they were very important persons in the political history of Rome. Okay? Next, children. These two people, here we see, first they made first triumvirate, Pompey, Crassus and Julius Caesar, isn't it? But what happened here, these two people were to be remembered ever, once again, it means, here we see the two people are very important in political history of Rome. They were Julius Caesar and Augustus Caesar, understood? These two people were to be remembered even today also, isn't it? Now, political history of Rome, they contributed much for the political aspects. They lived different regions as the military generals. Who? Pompey, Crassus and Julius Caesar. They formed first triumvirate in Rome. Understood? They formed the government. They lived different regions as the military generals. They were taking decisions very strictly, almost military rule. They were military generals. Why means they wanted to control the people of Rome. They wanted to control the people in in Rome a very effective manner. So they were not ruling like kings or queens. Understood? They were not ruling like kings. They were very strict with the people. They were very strict with the people. That is why there were very good administration in the ancient rule. Okay? Okay, children. Now we study about Julius Caesar. He was a very powerful king in Rome. See here. Now we study about, we learn about, we discuss here Julius Caesar. Julius Caesar. With the death of Crassus, with the death of Crassus, rivalry for power grew between Pompey and Julius Caesar. Okay, see here, there were three persons. They were made first triumvirate in Rome. Understood? Who? Pompey, Crassus and Julius Caesar. But later, what happened, children? There were three persons. Who are they? Pompey, Crassus and Julius Caesar. Later, what happened? Crassus died rivalry. Here, we see Crassus already died. Crassus died rivalry means competition, the conflict. Okay, there was clashes between the Pompey and then clashes between the Pompey and Caesar. First, who died? Crassus died. Understood? Crassus died and then conflict between Pompey and Julius Caesar. Okay, here we see one person is no more. Who was he? Crassus, isn't it? In the war which followed, Pompey was murdered by Julius Caesar. Next, who died here? Who murdered here? Pompey. Pompey also murdered by Julius Caesar. It was very common thing, children, to occupy the throne or come to the power. People were ready to kill the opponent also. He defeated Egypt. Next, Julius Caesar defeated Egypt. He defeated the Egypt. Julius Caesar defeated the Egypt. Egypt is in the northern part of the African continent. Okay. Julius Caesar went to the Egypt for war, but he was fell in love with Cleopatra, the beautiful Egyptian queen, Cleopatra. The Cleopatra was the queen of Egypt civilization or Egypt. Understood? When Julius Caesar went to the Egypt for war, but he was fell in the love with the Egyptian, the beautiful Egyptian queen, Cleopatra. Understood? She was very famous. Why she was famous? Famous because her beauty. She known for her beauty. Understood? Cleopatra was beautiful woman. She was queen of Egypt. Understood? When Julius Caesar went to the Egypt for war, what happened? But he fell in the love with the beautiful Egyptian queen Cleopatra. She known for her beauty. Understood? Next, Julius Caesar became a dictator. Julius Caesar became a dictator. Dictator means what, children? Sarvadhikari. Dictator means what? Sarvadhikari. Julius Caesar became a dictator means one who rules according to his own rule. He is called dictator. Understood? He will do not listen to anybody. He made himself a dictator. Who made himself a dictator here? Julius Caesar made himself a dictator and he abolished the Republic of Rome. He destroyed the Republic of Rome. He abolished the Republic of Rome. Understood? Because he did not like Republic. He became a dictator. That's why he abolished the Republic of Rome. Republic means what, children? State in which powers is held by the people. Understood? And there will be no king or queen, but there will be president. So India also very good. India also republican. Understood? From a government where people are taking part in the directly affairs of the government. Okay. Next, so in this step, he was assassinated. Who was assassinated? Julius Caesar was assassinated by his enemies. He became dictator. But what happened, children? People did not like dictator. People did not like him because he was a dictator. Who? Julius Caesar. He was a dictator. That's why people did not like him. Okay. Dictatorship was not liked by common people. What happened? There was later lot of violence. So he was assassinated. Who? Julius Caesar was assassinated. There was lot of violence, means killed or murdered by the enemies. Okay. During Caesar, he was assassinated. That's why he was killed by or murdered by the his enemies. Okay. During Caesar period, agriculture, industry and trade flourished or progressed. Okay. Julian calendar was introduced. During his period, Julian calendar was introduced during his period. People of Rome began to follow the Julian calendar, which was started in the period of the Julius Caesar. Understood, children? See here. Now, we have Roman Nagarikathaya bagge tilkolta idivi. Already now previous class alli ancient andre prachina nagarikategala bagge now tilkondidivi. For example, Egypt nagarikate, and then China nagarikate, Greek nagarikategala bagge now already tilkondidivi alva. Ivaga now Roman nagarikateya bagge ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಅಂದರೆ ಯುರೋಪಿನ ದಕ್ಷಿಣ ಮೆಡಿಟರೇನಿಯನ್ ಸಮುದ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಉದ್ದವಾಗಿ ಚಾಚಿಕೊಂಡಿರುವಂತಹ ಪರ್ಯಾಯ ದ್ವೀಪವೇ ಇಟಲಿ. ಪೆನಿನ್ಸುಲಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಪರ್ಯಾಯ ದ್ವೀಪ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟಾಲಿಯನ್ನರು ಎಂಬ ಬುಡಕಟ್ಟು ಜನಾಂಗ ಅಥವಾ ಸಮುದಾಯ ವಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. 2700 ವರ್ಷಗಳ ಹಿಂದೆ ಟೈಬರ್ ನದಿಯ ದಂಡೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ರೋಮ್ ಎಂಬ ಜನವಸತಿ ಪ್ರದೇಶ ಹುಟ್ಟಿಕೊಂಡಿತ್ತು. ಅಂದರೆ ರೋಮ್ ಎಂಬ ಜನವಸತಿ ಪ್ರದೇಶ ಯಾವ ನದಿಯ ದಂಡೆಯ ಮೇಲೆ ಹುಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿತ್ತು? ಟೈಬರ್ ನದಿಯ ದಂಡೆಯ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದರ ಉಗಮ ಆಗಿತ್ತು. ಓಕೆ. ರೋಮನ್ನರ ಮೂಲ ಪುರುಷರು ಯಾರು? ರೋಮುಲಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ರೀಮಸ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟೂಡ್? ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಲಿಸನ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ರೋಮನ್ನರ ಮೂಲ ಪುರುಷರು ರೋಮುಲಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೀಮಸ್. ಎನ್ಸೆಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ಮೂಲ ಪುರುಷರು ಅಂದರೆ ancestors of Rome. Who are the ancestors of Rome? Romulus and Remus. They were the ancestors of Rome. Understood? ಇವಾಗ ನಾವು ರಾಜಕೀಯ ಇತಿಹಾಸದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಓಕೆ. ಮುಂದೆ ರೋಮಿನ ರಾಜಕೀಯ ಇತಿಹಾಸದಲ್ಲಿ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಪ್ರಮುಖರಾಗಿದ್ದವರು. ಯಾರು? ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್. ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ರಾಸಸ್, ಪಾಂಪೆ ಮತ್ತು ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಇವರು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಇವರು ಮೂರು ಜನರನ್ನು ಒಳಗೊಂಡಿರುವಂತಹ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಆಡಳಿತ ರೋಮಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಮೂರು ಜನ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡು ಒಂದು ಒಕ್ಕೂಟವನ್ನು ಅವರು ರಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ಮೊದಲ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಆಡಳಿತ ಅಂದರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರಿಮ್ಯುರೇಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೆಯಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರ್ಯಾರಿದ್ದಾರೆ? ಪಾಂಪೆ, ಕ್ರಾಸಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್. ಈ ಮೂರು ಜನರನ್ನು ಒಳಗೊಂಡಿರುವಂತಹ ಮೊದಲ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಆಡಳಿತ ರೋಮಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ. ಈ ಮೂವರು ದಂಡನಾಯಕನಾಗಿ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯ ರೋಮ್ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯದ ವಿವಿಧ ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇವರು ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಾ ಪ್ರಮುಖವಾಗಿರುವಂತಹ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಯಾರು? ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್. ಇವನೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಇವನ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರಿಗೆ ಇವನೊಬ್ಬ ಸರ್ವಾಧಿಕಾರಿಯಾಗಿರ್ತಾನೆ. ಇವನು ಆಡಳಿತವನ್ನ ತನ್ನ ಆಡಳಿತವನ್ನ ಹಂಚಿಕೆ ಮಾಡುವುದು ಇವನಿಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾರಿಗೆ? ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ಗೆ. ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ಇವನೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಕ್ರಾಸಸ್ನ ಸಾಯಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಆಡಳಿತದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರ್ಯಾರು ಇರ್ತಾರೆ? ಕ್ರಾಸಸ್, ಪಾಂಪೆ ಅಂಡ್ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಕ್ರಾಸಸ್ನನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಸಾಯಿಸಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ನಂತರ ಅಧಿಕಾರಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಪಾಂಪೆ ಮತ್ತು ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ನ ನಡುವೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಕಚ್ಚಾಟ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ಪರ್ಧೆ ಏರ್ಪಡುತ್ತೆ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇವ್ರೇನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಕ್ರಾಸಸ್ನ ಅವರು ಹೊರ ದೂಕ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನನ್ನ ಸಾಯಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ನಂತರ ಉಳಿದಿರೋರು ಯಾರಿಲ್ಲಿ? ಪಾಂಪೆ ಮತ್ತು ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್. ಇವರ ನಡುವೆ ಅಧಿಕಾರಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಸ್ಪರ್ಧೆ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂತಿಮವಾಗಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಪಾಂಪೆಯನ್ನು ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಸಾಯಿಸ್ತಾನೆ ಅಥವಾ ಕೊಲ್ತಾನೆ. ಓಕೆ, ನಂತರ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಈಜಿಪ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಗೆದ್ದು ಅಲ್ಲಿನ ರಾಣಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯೋಪಾತ್ರಳ ಪ್ರೀತಿಯನ್ನ ಗಳಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಯಾರು? ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಸರ್ವಾಧಿಕಾರಿಯಾದ ನಂತರ, ಸರ್ವಾಧಿಕಾರಿ ಆಗುವ ಮೂಲಕ ರೋಮ್ನ ಗಣರಾಜ್ಯ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆಯನ್ನು ಅವನೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ? ನಾಶಪಡಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಗಣರಾಜ್ಯ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ರೋಮ್ನಲ್ಲಿ, ಇದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆ ಗಣರಾಜ್ಯ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದನ್ನು ಇವನು ಯಾವಾಗ ಸರ್ವಾಧಿಕಾರಿ ಆಗ್ತಾನೆ, ರೋಮಿನ ಸರ್ವಾಧಿಕಾರಿಯಾದ ನಂತರ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿನ ಗಣರಾಜ್ಯ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆಯನ್ನು ಅವನೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ? ನಾಶ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಇದನ್ನು ನೆಪ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ನ ವಿರೋಧಿಗಳು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಆ ರೋಮಿನ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಇವನ ಸರ್ವಾಧಿಕಾರತ್ವ ಇಷ್ಟ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕಡೆ ಇವನ ಶತ್ರುಗಳ ಬಣವೂ ಕೂಡ ಬೆಳೀತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಒಂದಿನ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಈ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ನನ್ನು ಈ ಶತ್ರುಗಳು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ? ಸಾಯಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಇದನ್ನು ನೆಪ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು, ಯಾವಾಗ ಅವನು ರೋಮಿನ ಗಣರಾಜ್ಯ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆಯನ್ನು ನಾಶಪಡಿಸ್ತಾನೆ, ಅದನ್ನು ನೆಪ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಅವನ ಎನಿಮಿಗಳು, ಅವನ ಶತ್ರುಗಳು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ? ಈ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ನನ್ನು ಸಾಯಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ರೋಮಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೃಷಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ರಂಗದಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಪ್ರಗತಿಯನ್ನು ರೋಮ್ ಸಾಧಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಕೃಷಿ, ಕೈಗಾರಿಕೆ ಇರಬಹುದು, ವ್ಯಾಪಾರ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳು ಇರಬಹುದು, ಎಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ರೋಮ್ ಇವನ ಕಾಲಾವಧಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಪ್ರಗತಿಯನ್ನು ಸಾಧಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾರ ಕಾಲಾವಧಿಯಲ್ಲಿ? ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ನ ಕಾಲಾವಧಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ರೋಮ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ರಂಗದಲ್ಲಿಯೂ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಪ್ರಗತಿಯನ್ನು ಸಾಧಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಇವನ ಕಾಲಾವಧಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೂಲಿಯನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲೆಂಡರನ್ನು ಅವನು ಜಾರಿಗೆ ತರ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ರೋಮಿನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜನರು ಕೂಡ ಈ ಜೂಲಿಯನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲೆಂಡರನ್ನು ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಅಗಸ್ಟ ಸೀಸರ್ ಮುಂದುವರಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಇವರ ಮರಣದ ನಂತರ ಬಂದಂತಹ ಅಗಸ್ಟ ಸೀಸರ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ? ಇವನ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು, ಜನಾಭಿವೃದ್ಧಿ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಅವನು ಮುಂದುವರಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ನಾವು ವಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್. ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವೆರಿ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇನ್ ರೋಮನ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ. ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ರೋಮನ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್? ಓಕೆ, ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಹಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನೇಮ್ ವಾಸ್ Octavius was the first name of Augustus Caesar. His first name was Octavius. Octavius was the first name of Augustus Caesar. Okay, Mark Antony, once again children, Mark Antony, Lepidus and Octavius formed the second triumvirate. Once again children, here we see repeat. Augustus Caesar also, he formed second triumvirate. Understood? Here we see Mark Antony in first triumvirate, who made the first triumvirate? Crassus, Pompey and Julius Caesar, isn't it? Here we see second triumvirate. They made second triumvirate Mark Antony, Lepidus and Octavius. They formed second triumvirate. Triumvirate. Again, repeated here, children. They formed second triumvirate. Who formed second triumvirate? Mark Antony, Lepidus, and Augustus Caesar. They formed second triumvirate. Mark Antony, Lepidus, and Augustus Caesar, they made the second triumvirate, children. Once again, three persons who had the thorough knowledge of law, thorough knowledge about the law and the government, and very powerful. They were very powerful. Understood? All the three joined and formed the second triumvirate. Government by the three persons started in the Rome. Okay. Octavius shared power with Mark Antony. That means Augustus Caesar, he was ready to share power with the Mark Antony. But what happened? But here drove away the Lepidus. Here also drove away the Lepidus. They did not like the Lepidus. Who did not like the Lepidus? Augustus Caesar did not like the Lepidus. Three persons are there. He was just with Mark Antony. He shared his power with the Mark Antony. But he did not like Lepidus. That's why Augustus Caesar and Mark Antony by drawing away the Lepidus. He was adjust with Mark Antony, but he did not like Lepidus. Here also same situation, children. Lepidus sent out or drove away or defeated by the Augustus Caesar. Okay. Lepidus finally defeated Antony also. Julius Caesar, first he defeated the Lepidus, and then he defeated the Antony. Also, once again, Augustus Caesar became a dictator of Rome. Once again, Augustus Caesar also became a dictator of Rome. Understood? He also became dictator. Sarvadhikari. He also became dictator of Rome. He never wanted other person to share the government. What happened? Mark Antony, Lepidus and Octavius formed the second triumvirate. Lepidus was went out and the Mark Antony also defeated by Augustus Caesar. Now Augustus Caesar there in the Rome government. He became a dictator of Rome. Who became a dictator of Rome? Augustus Caesar became a dictator of Rome. Okay. Octavius became the most powerful man in the Roman Empire. His period is known as the Golden Age. Whose period known as the Golden Age? Augustus Caesar or Octavius period was known as the Golden Age. Golden Age. Once again, Rome saw the all-round development during his period. In almost all fields, achievements are progressed. Jesus Christ live in that period. Jesus Christ lived in that period. Who was he? Jesus Christ was the founder of Christianity. Jesus Christ was the founder of Christianity. Very popular. Christianity, it is very popular religion. Almost all European countries, 72 to 80% of European countries are following Christianity. Isn't it? Because the simple teachings, one God is behind, that is principle attracting many countries. This is the principle people have the oneness. Here we see once again, children, Jesus Christ lived in his, during his period. Jesus Christ lived in that period. Jesus Christ was the founder of Christianity. Okay. He introduced the many social reforms. And the rule was peaceful. This period was called Roman peace. Understood? Roman peace, because this period was called Roman peace. Roman peace. This period was called Roman peace because administration very peaceful. All-round development, no violence, economic and cultural progress was achieved in during this period. That means agriculture, trade, commerce, music, along with cultural progress, there was all-round development in the fields also. The successors of Augustus were successors means what, children? Next generation. The successors of Augustus were incompetent. They were very weak. Understood? They were not powerful. They were defeated by the tribal invaders. Understood? Once again, children, the successors of Augustus, incompetent. They were very weak. They were not powerful. That's why what happened? They were defeated by the tribal invaders. Okay? Some powerful tribal people. Okay? Were there. They were defeated by the tribal invaders. They defeated the successors of Augustus, which resulted in the decline of Roman Empire. Thus, the progress also declined. Okay, when there is no powerful king, when there is no good administration, naturally what happened? The government also not good, isn't it? That empire was declined. It happened to lead to the downfall of the Roman Empire. Okay, children, now ivaga yara bagge telkondidivi? Julius Caesar na nantara ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ನ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಅಂದರೆ ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ರೋಮನ ರಾಜಕೀಯ ಇತಿಹಾಸದಲ್ಲಿ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ತುಂಬ ಪ್ರಮುಖರಾಗಿರುವಂತಹ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳು ಅಂತಲೇ ನಾವು ಹೇಳಬಹುದು. ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ದ, ಅವನು ಕೂಡ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಆಡಳಿತವನ್ನು, ಮೊದಲನೆಯ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಆಡಳಿತವನ್ನು ಅವನು ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಆದರೆ ಅವನು ಕೂಡ ಇಬ್ಬರನ್ನ ಸೋಲಿಸಿ, ಇಬ್ಬರನ್ನ ಹತ್ಯೆಗೈದು ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಕೂಡ ರೋಮಿನ ಸರ್ವಾಧಿಕಾರಿಯಾಗ್ತಾನೆ, ಹೌದಲ್ವಾ. ನಂತರ ಇವನಂತೆಯೇ ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಕೂಡ, ಅಂದರೆ ಇವನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್, ಇವನ ನಂತರ ಬಂದಿರುವಂತಹ ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ಕೂಡ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಭಿವೃದ್ಧಿ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಅವನು ರೋಮ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಂದುವರಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ನ ಮೊದಲ ಹೆಸರು ನಾವು ಇವಾಗ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್. ಇವನ ಮೊದಲ ಹೆಸರು ಆಕ್ಟೇವಿಯಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅವನು ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಆಂಟೋನಿ, ಲೆಪಿಡಸ್ ಜೊತೆ ಸೇರಿ ಎರಡನೇ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಆಡಳಿತವನ್ನು ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಇವನು ಕೂಡ ಎರಡನೇ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಒಂದು ಒಕ್ಕೂಟವನ್ನು ರಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರ್ಯಾರಿದ್ದಾರೆ? ಲೆಪಿಡಸ್, ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಆಂಟೋನಿ ಮತ್ತು ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇವರು ಮೂರು ಜನರನ್ನು ಒಳಗೊಂಡಿರುವಂತಹ ಎರಡನೇ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಆಡಳಿತ ರೋಮಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಲೆಪಿಡಸ್ಸನನ್ನು ಓಡಿಸಿ, ಅಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರಿಗೆ ಆಡಳಿತವನ್ನು ಹಂಚಿಕೆ ಮಾಡೋದು ಇಷ್ಟ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಅವನೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಲೆಪಿಡಸ್ ನನ್ನ ಓಡಿಸ್ತಾನೆ, ಆಂಟೋನಿಯ ಜೊತೆ ರಾಜ್ಯವನ್ನ ಅವನು ಹಂಚ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ನಂತರ ಆಂಟೋನಿಯನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಇವನು ಸೋಲಿಸ್ತಾನೆ, ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೋಲಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಅನಂತರ ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ನನ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಧಿಕಾರಗಳನ್ನು ತನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇಂದ್ರೀಕರಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ಅವನು ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಇವನು ಕೂಡ ಅಲ್ಲಿನ ಸರ್ವಾಧಿಕಾರಿಯಾಗಿ ಆಡಳಿತವನ್ನ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ನ ಕಾಲವನ್ನ ರೋಮಿನ ಸುವರ್ಣ ಯುಗ, ಗೋಲ್ಡನ್ ಏಜ್ ಎಂದು ಕರೆಯಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಏಸು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತ ಕೂಡ ಇವನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿಯೇ ಬದುಕಿದ್ದ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏಸು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತ ಕ್ರೈಸ್ತ ಧರ್ಮದ ಸ್ಥಾಪಕ. ಅಗಸ್ತಸನು ಅನೇಕ ಲೋಕ ಉಪಯೋಗಿ ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸಮಾಜ ಸುಧಾರಣೆಯನ್ನ ಇವನು ಅನೇಕ ಲೋಕ ಉಪಯೋಗಿ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನ ಇವನು ಕೈಗೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಈ ಕಾಲವನ್ನ ರೋಮಿನ ಶಾಂತಿಯ ಕಾಲ ಎಂದು ಕರೆಯಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಈ ಅವಧಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ರೋಮ್ ಆರ್ಥಿಕವಾಗಿ ಇರಬಹುದು, ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕವಾಗಿ ಇರಬಹುದು, ಎಲ್ಲಾ ರಂಗದಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಪ್ರಗತಿಯನ್ನ ಸಾಧಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ ನಂತರದ ಅಂದರೆ ಅಗಸ್ಟಸ್ನ ನಂತರ ಬಂದಿರುವಂತಹ ದೊರೆಗಳು ತುಂಬ ಅಸಮರ್ಥರಾಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಮುಂದೆ ಬುಡಕಟ್ಟು ಜನಾಂಗದ ದಾಳಿಗೆ ತುತ್ತಾಗಿ ಈ ರೋಮನ್ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯ ಕಣ್ಮರೆಯಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಥವಾ ನಾಶ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್.